Mrs. Blake saw a tall, heavy man with dark hair carrying a case and a light overcoat over his arm at Victoria Station. Pointing towards the man, Mrs. Blake asked her husband whether he knew him. Mr. Blake told her that he had never seen that person. He asked his wife whether she wanted to read a newspaper. Mrs. Blake told him that she had read it in the morning. Then Mr. Blake bought a ticket and a magazine for her. She took her seat in a first-class carriage and Mr. Blake left for his office. Mrs. Blake started reading her magazine. Then, just as the train was going to start, the tall, dark man got in. He put his overcoat and case on the luggage rack and sat down facing her. As soon as the train started, he took out a newspaper and began to read. Mrs. Blake looked at him and suddenly she remembered she had seen the picture of this man in the morning newspaper. This man had killed someone and police was looking after him. Now the man was sitting with her in an empty compartment of a train traveling at 60 miles an hour. Mrs. Blake was frightened. What ought she to do? She thought of pulling the chain of the train, but she was not sure. Moreover, she thought that if she had tried to pull the chain, the man might harm her. The man was still reading the newspaper and she went on watching him over her magazine. After some time, the man put down his newspaper and looked out of the window. Mrs. Blake, by then, was very sure that he was the killer about whom she had read. She also remembered that the newspaper said that a killer always uses a knife. Suddenly, she noticed that the man's hand moved towards the pocket of his coat and slowly he took out a knife. Carefully, he opened the blade, a long blade, pointed at the end. Mrs. Blake wanted to jump to her feet and scream for help, but she was too frightened to move. Then she saw man's other hand move towards his pocket. Mrs. Blake thought that he was looking for a handkerchief to cover her face so that she could not scream. But the man took out an apple and began to peel it. Mrs. Blake was relieved. But the man then started looking at her. His deep, dark eyes were never moving. Mrs. Blake was sure that now he was going to kill her. At that moment, the train began to slow down. The train stopped at Eastbourne and the man stood up. Mrs. Blake was sure that the man was a killer, for two policemen were waiting at the platform for him. As the man got down, the two policemen saluted him smartly and wished him good morning and called him Inspector. As soon as they walked away, Mrs. Blake took up the newspaper which was lying in the seat. On the front page there were two pictures, one of a small man with thin lips and another of the big dark man. She now knew so well. Under the first picture was written Jack, the killer, and under the second was written Inspector Thornton of Scotland Yard, in charge of the case.